In India, sibling relationships are considered absolutely good and better than anywhere else in the world. Our epics like Ramayana celebrate Ram and Lakshman, where Lakshman followed Ram to the end of the world and back. But in reality, is that what happens? In my experience as a therapist in the last 15 years, one thing that I have realized is sibling relationship is something that gives a lot of clues about a family relationship, yet nobody talks about it in as much detail. A lot of times, people just say, oh, siblings are like that. They tend to fight. What is the big deal? Well, you would be surprised to know that yes, it is a big deal. The way siblings relate to each other says a lot about their early childhood and how is it that they grew up. So let's see. Firstly, why is it that sibling rivalry is seen in some families and not in others? Most of the time, sibling rivalry is there when there is an ongoing conflict between children who are raised in the same family. It can be between blood-related siblings, step-siblings, or any other family structure which is there. So what are some of the common causes of intense sibling rivalry? The first one is lack of structure while growing up. A lot of parents do not set firm boundaries. For example, if a pizza comes in, who is going to get how many slices is left very vague. So sometimes simple things like meal times become a battleground where each one fights as though in the jungle. Whoever gets the lion's share gets, but the others just have to fend for themselves. So lack of structure in early growing years is a very strong cause of sibling rivalry. In fact, I see so many adults in their 40s or 50s who speak about how one child got a video game to play with and yet the other one just had to adjust and compromise, either because they were older or because they were not as strong as the other sibling. So parents, if you want children not to have sibling rivalry between them, ensure that there is a proper structure in place. Ensure that there are healthy boundaries and proper rules and regulations. Children tend to thrive in good rule and regulation. A second factor that is seen where people have intense sibling rivalry, whether we talk about business families that we know about, you know, where both the brothers are fighting, whether it's in the realm of petroleum or they may be in the Fortune 500 company, it's also because parents have given either negative attention or no attention. In simple words, it means if one child cried or complained, the parent usually responded either by scolding or by spanking one of them or both of them. So when children grow up in such a charged up political atmosphere or because the parent is very busy to give them time, they tend to view each other as rivals or people who are competing for attention from the parent. So how can you deal with it? Firstly, how you deal with it is acknowledge that there is sibling rivalry. Also, if the relationship is something which you prize but don't know what to do about, have a proper conversation with yourself. Do you see space for compassionate, loving, helpful and empathetic relationship between each other? What is being compassionate? Being compassionate means where you can really empathize with the other, understand how it is to be in the other person's skin and yet not pass snide comments. Often you will have adults who pass comments on each other, the other's style of dressing up or their choice of mate, their children, their food habits. So when these kind of relationship patterns are there, then there is not much scope for compassion, empathy, love, or helpful patterns. So what do you do if visiting a family gathering makes you feel absolutely tired because you know your sibling is going to pick on you, pass comments, or engage you in an allocation that you do not want to be a part of. Firstly, ask yourself, do you have a toxic sibling? Absolutely. It sounds very horrible, but how I look at it is if you acknowledge that how bad something is for your mental equilibrium, you will do something about it. So if you get into arguments or your mood gets spoiled, so whose responsibility is it to ensure that you feel good? Yes, you got that right. It's you yourself. And it's not about the other person. Because when you are calm, compassionate, and loving, frankly, no one can move you from that zone. So what we are trying to do here is anchor ourselves into our own true nature rather than distract or, you know, the other or get pulled into drama that we are not interested in. So when we start knowing our relationships around us only from the lens of self-improvement, then we can definitely do something about it. In the next video, I will be talking about 10 signs to watch out for that you know that your sibling is toxic for you, and then what is it that you need to do to stay anchored in your space of loving compassion and grow mindfully. Take care and have a good day.